I haven't even showed the birdie animation yet, and it's already been three holes. Two bogeys and a birdie. I mean, two bogeys and a par. Dang it. Okay, here's where the booze really come into play. This hole right here. You want to... these booze are also very random. You want to try and curve your ball to go around these booze, if possible. Around and over these booze, if you can. Don't count on doing a perfect shot every time on this hole. The way the booze are on this hole, this is a really bad formation this time. I'm almost better off hitting that bob on over there. That's another new aspect to this game, or this course, is those bombs. Oh shoot, I'm gonna have to miss hit this shot on purpose. If I hit the bob-ombs, they explode and push my ball in the opposite direction of the explosion, and oh my god, that turned out a lot better than I thought it would. Than I ever thought it would. Wow. Just wow. Very, very dark area. I hope this doesn't mess with the camera. I don't think it will. Because the whole, most, I should say the majority of the area is dark. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, come on! It's like this course doesn't want me to birdie. I am a very sad dinosaur. Dinosaur slash dragon. Whatever the heck he is. He seems to be like a hybrid. One game he's shooting fire, the other one he's spitting out his tongue. I don't know what the heck he is. He's just a drug addicted critter, I know that for sure. And I'm gonna hit my ball over here. Don't hit it too far, otherwise you'll have a very, very hard shot to the pin. And yeah, that's pretty good. I probably should have put backspin on that, but it turned out well. Just backspin just to control the ball, I should say. Let's see. Don't hit the ball too far here, and don't hit it too short, otherwise you'll hit the bob-omb. Lava and bob-ombs are not your ball's friend. This is going to be another hard putt for me to get birdie on. I just can't seem to put my ball in any position to get a birdie, an easy birdie, I should say. Oh, did I get it? Did I get it? Yes! Finally a birdie! I needed that. Gulliver? That's from Animal Crossing, isn't it? If you ever noticed the leaderboards on Mario Golf, I should say, you can see a lot of characters from a lot of different Nintendo games. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Gulliver, they're referring to the Animal Crossing series. Oh, boy. By the way, that's not heavy rough, that's regular rough. It's just that the rough looks really, really ragged on this golf course compared to other courses. Come to think of it, all the grass looks pretty ragged on this course compared to other courses, but that's just the look of the course. You know, it's supposed to be a really dark, nasty-looking course, and it does its job. Another birdie for Yoshi! And I'm back to even par. I'm pretty sure all you need is even par to beat this course, but I, of course, want to shoot at least 5-6 under par, because that's just my way. this green, because of all the bumps and humps on it, is really, really hard to hit. There's just so many things that'll... if you hit it short like that, you'll go in the bunker. You hit it long, you could go in the lava. It's just really hard to control it. Come on, chip in. Chippin', 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 chippin'. Okay, maybe I am doing a lot better today than I was the other day. Because I am playing a lot harder courses than I was the other day before. Oh! This is an awesome hole right here. Just look at this. Set on the side of a volcano. This hole is epic. Shortman Designer made a point on this hole here that I should definitely mention. When you play match games on this hole, he said it was somewhere around hole 9, but it was definitely this hole right here. If you play a match game against a computer, like a high-level computer like Mario or something, what they'll do is they'll either aim straight towards the hole like this, switch to a putter at maximum power, and just putt themselves right into the lava or rocks or whatever. Or what they'll do is they'll take a wedge right from the driver, and then they'll hit over to this rough over here. I don't know why they do that. It's like a glitch in the game's AI or something like that, but it's pretty dang funny when it happens. To keep the games fair for the computers, What I do is, if they do that, I just save and quit the hole and restart the hole until they do something proper. It sometimes takes a lot of tries for them to do something proper. Honestly, they play this hole worse than any human could possibly play this hole that has gotten this far in the game. I am dead serious. I might show that later just for the lulls, because it is pretty dang funny. I have to hit this underneath that rock arch over there, so I'm going to use a driver. I would not normally recommend using a driver because of how hard it is to hit and how low the impact area goes, but in this case, I'm going to have to use a driver to get low enough underneath that rock arch there, and this shot to the green is pretty hard here. So, I recommend you play it as safe as possible, with some nice backspin to control it, and, yeah, hope for the best. Even a safe shot is pretty risky over here, because there's heath, lava, deep rough, it's nasty. That's a pretty decent shot. I will accept the shot with grace. I got a lot of fringe putt through, so I'm going to hit it with a lot of power. Yeah, baby! Oh yeah, things are turning around for my little dinosaur slash dragon druggy friend. Yeah. You know Yoshi loves his fuzzy spores, and that's where he gets his golfing skill from. It just relaxes him, and he's able to play golf like a pro. That's how he hits it so straight, so accurately, and with such a great impact area. That's also why he's my favorite golfer in this game. Other than Neil, of course, from the Game Boy Advance games. Because you can raise him to be so awesome, and I should not have put maximum backspin on it. That's why. The more you make the ball roll on this side of the green, the more chance it has to roll itself right into the bunker. I'm going to try for the chip-in. It's not going to happen, but I'm going to try for it. Or I could just hit the pin like that. That works pretty well, too. And go for power. By the way, in case you didn't notice, I was hitting inside a giant Bowser head at this front door here. To Bowser's castle, to the inside of Bowser's castle. I gotta say, Bowser makes quite an awesome golf course. Seriously. I'm going to play for the fast fairway on this one, just to see how much distance I can get, because this hole is really long, and this is not going to go on the fast fairway at all, but the rough over there, which actually isn't that bad of a shot. Oh, I forgot to mention also to you, see these thwomps? Yeah, these thwomps right here. These are actually Mario 64-style thwomps, not the newer gray, rectangular, spiky edge thwomps. If you ever land your ball on one of those shadows right underneath them, they'll thwomp down on your ball and give you the worst possible ball lie you can get from wherever you land the ball. Like, if you're in the fairway, it'll make the ball land in, like, a divot impression in the fairway. So, try not to land your ball where those thwomps are. And I'm going to use the fast fairway to my advantage to see if I can get up to the green. And that was unsuccessful. But that's to be expected when you play the ball into the rough accidentally, like I did. Come on, chip in. Now I'm just trying for the chip-ins for the fun of it. Whoa, my goodness! I will accept that shot as a good shot.
Mmm! I do fuzzy spores!
Next hole, number 11. Gonna be awesome, and I'm already ahead of the competition. No one's shooting under par. They're shooting even or better. Oh, this hole is so hard! It takes place on this clown car here. This green is so hard to hit, and it's so easy to go in the water that you're almost better off playing it safe. And fun fact here, if you hit those propellers, nothing happens. Your ball goes right through the propellers. I've tried it before on the fun practice rounds, and you just go right through the propellers. I was expecting, like, if you were to hit those propellers, it would make the ball, like, fly out of control somewhere, which would have been pretty dang funny to see, but alas, it just goes right through them. Chip in. Oh my god, I almost got another one. Oh, that was way too much power. That was just stupid of me. I should have waited for the power meter to go back. I just got too excited on that one. That was easily a par. But oh well, I'll just be a sad dinosaur this time around and sit on my bum. This is a pretty cool looking hole. It's so intimidating, but it's actually not hard at all. Even to get a birdie on. You just want to play anywhere on the fairway on these upper tiers. Just as long as you don't get in front of one of those bob-ombs or underneath one of those spikes. And then you just have a nice clear shot to the green. The only problem with this hole is that it is really, really long. The pin is at the upper tier, at least in this case, you want to roll the ball to that upper tier, if you can. I think this is going to be a pretty good shot. Yeah! See, this hole isn't that hard at all. It's just really long. And it looks intimidating, but it's really not at all. But it is a really cool looking hole.
Real!
He makes the sounds that I like and that I make myself.